Joining us now to look at the challenges and prospects for the pharmaceutical sector as growing populations present opportunities in Africa is Kofie Amagashie, Head of Operations at Africa at Pharmaceutical Group Adcock Ingram. When we talk about Africa, we're talking about a continent that's almost a billion people. Some people say we're already at a billion. Anyway, the UN says today all of us combined together in the whole world, we're now 7 billion. We know roughly about a billion of those people live in Africa. For companies like yours, that presents an opportunity, particularly given the rapid population growth that we've seen in Africa, the fastest population growth rates in the whole world at just over 3% versus other parts of the world where that population growth is declining. How big is Africa as an opportunity for a drug maker like you guys?
Well, Africa is the last frontier for drug maker like ourselves. It's largely unserviced. Access to healthcare in Africa is woefully low, and as governments try to achieve their Millennium Development Goals, access, broadening healthcare access is very important. The recent events in North Africa have forced a lot of governments like Morocco to basically adopt policies that broaden access. A lot of these countries have been closed to us from a regulatory viewpoint, but as they begin to open up with young populations, populations that are not very wealthy, companies like ourselves that have affordable medication, the opportunity is now.
Absolutely. You know, if I had one word with God one time, if I were just to meet him face to face, I'd just ask him one thing. Just make all the world governments efficient, because in it lies a challenge for companies like yours, regulation. When we look at regulation across Africa, it's of course different in all the kinds of geographies that you have to traverse when you, if you're getting into Africa. Are you finding that regulation is actually improving and you're getting governments that understand the need to ensure that there's proper, stable regulation across all industries, including of course the pharmaceuticals?
I think regulation on the continent is on a continuum. Yeah. There are some countries that have extremely good regulation with very little small markets.
Are we able to put them into blocks?
Very difficult. I mean, I just came back from Ethiopia yesterday. Brilliant regulation, but the markets are still not open. All right. The ability to police regulation is very good. You get into other countries that shall remain nameless, where the ability to police the regulation, which a very good regulation on the books, is not there. But the important thing is, we look sort of harmonization of regulation, because that affects the cost of doing business, and consequently the price for the consumer. If you take the SADC area, I mean, I think it's a laudable goal to look at uniform regulation across Africa.
Yeah, which of course makes it easy for you guys.
But I mean, practically, you know, it will be a more practically achievable goal to look at regional economic community harmonization of regulation at first. If you take SADC, the regulation on packaging is very different, right?
Within SADC.
Within SADC.
Which is trying to harmonize trade policies as well as...
And what this does, it means you have customization in the production line.
Right.
And if you've got small volumes across the smaller countries, you're really not cost effective.
Yeah.
So the ability to decouple the customization from the production line will help. Will be helped by regulation that is harmonized across.
But regulation is particularly important for the drug sector, isn't it? Because you guys need to ensure that standards are met across the board, and you do need to make sure that that is a standard across all, across the regions that you operate in.
Well,
if you heard the guest that I had before you came in was talking about the flat earth. I wish you could have a flat SADC region or a flat ECOWAS that looks at regulation in the same way and ensures the same standards.
That would be first prize. That would be utopia. The thing is, in the first instance, the consumer regulation has to protect the consumer.
Right.
That's paramount.
That's key.
That's key. What we look for to be able to improve access, uniform regulation across geographies will help you get into a market with scale and scope economies.
And cut down on costs.
Absolutely. But the important thing is, as we look at regulation across our continent, the ability to create the rules and then form institutions that govern those rules.
Those rules.
And then have people who are committed to enforcing those governance processes is key.
And that's not the only challenge, is it? Because
indeed,
you also face
right
competition, you also have counterfeit drugs.
And counterfeit drugs is a very important problem. I mean, it's not like having a counterfeit Louis Vuitton bag. If you have counterfeit drugs, people die, right? So we're looking at innovative ways to ensure consumers purchase the right real drugs as we go forward.
Yeah. Which brings me to my original player. Please, God, just make sure all governments are efficient.
Indeed.